Billionaire entrepreneur Elon Musk has fueled hopes for manned missions to Mars, but the head of the European Space Agency says it could be decades before humans walk on the red planet. Both men were in Australia on Friday, with Mr. Musk addressing the International Astronautical Congress in Adelaide as ESA Director General Jan Warner visited Washington for the first time. In New Norcia, where one of only three ESA Deep Space ground stations has played an important role in communications for the Rosetta and Mars Express missions, Mr. Warner told reporters the fourth planet from the Sun was an enormous challenge. "I am quite sure humans will go back to the Moon in the next 50 years and maybe also to Mars, but Mars is a very special challenge. It's really hard," he said. "The trip to Mars takes about 2 years, and we do not have the technology right now to do so. Radiation is heavy. After 1 month or 2 months, you are developing some health issues and cannot return with today's technology. You have to go on for 2 years. Humans will go there, and I hope humans go even beyond, but not in the next 20 years, let's say 15 years. There is no real concrete project for that." Mr. Musk spoke of new space rockets he hopes will be able to service the International Space Station as well as establish human colonies on the Moon and Mars, and said the program could be funded by the money his SpaceX company receives for launching satellites. He believes he could send the first two cargo ships to the Red Planet by 2022, with the first two crewed craft touching down just 2 years later. The reusable rockets will lift a payload of more than 4,000 tons and feature 40 cabins, each capable of carrying three people, he says. Australian National University College of Science Associate Professor Charlie Linouver said the science behind Mr. Musk's plan was realistic. "The unrealistic part, the thing holding us back, has always been finding the political will to invest in space," Dr. Linouver said. "But Mr. Musk was not a committee," he said. "He shows what intelligence and money can do when they are combined." Mr. Warner also welcomed Australia's plan to create its own space agency, but advised against agonizing over where it will be headquartered. "Rather than going into a competition in Australia, I would say join forces and do something great out of it," he said. "Australia, this is the land of pioneers and dreamers, and so you are the best basis for space." COP 2017.